Police will need a wiretap warrant if they want access to a suspect's text messages. Canada's top court handed down a ruling earlier today. It was a split decision. The Supreme Court found that text messages are a form of private communication. So the bar to access them will now be set higher. It is the result of a case involving Telus Communications. The company went to court to quash a police request to access the text messages of two suspects who happen to be Telus customers. Scott Hutchison is lead lawyer representing Telus in the case, and he joins me right here in studio. You've got to be happy with this decision. Did you get what you went in for?
Certainly did. What the court has done here is clarified an area of the law that really needed to be clarified, and that's the relationship between efforts by the police to gather evidence from these new emerging technologies and how they relate to the regime that's been in place for a generation dealing with telephones. We all know that to get a wiretap, the police have to meet a very high threshold. There's only certain offenses that that kind of order can be obtained for, and they have to show the court that no other investigative technique is likely to advance their investigation in the same way. It's meant to give special protection to those communications because we know that those kinds of communications are really important. What Telus was presented with here was an order that had the effect of allowing the police to get access to that kind of information at a much lower threshold, simply grounds to believe there was an offense. Telus, because it takes its clients' privacy very seriously, went to court and challenged that order and did everything that it could to make sure that the police were held to a standard that was going to be consistent with everybody's expectations in terms of how the police should be able to access it.
Well, why should Canadians care about this? Because I would sense that some viewers watching this would say, well, you know, what if the bad guys are sending bad texts? Shouldn't police have access to that? But it's this balancing act between civil liberties and etc.
Absolutely, and the question really is, where does that balance get struck? Traditionally, with voice communications, we've said, we know bad guys use telephones too. They use telephones in the same way that they use text messages. And if you're going to make that argument, you better be ready to let the police have access to voice communications on the same basis. What this does is make sure that as there's this explosion of new technologies, new ways for people to communicate, that those get the same protection. And by bringing this case to the Supreme Court of Canada, Telus has protected its clients' expectations of privacy in those new communications, in SMS, in emails, in tweets, all of those things now, to the extent that you have, for example, a person-to-person tweet, those are now protected at the same level as a private communication, like a telephone call.
It's amazing how technology can change how we perceive things to be private communication or not, because you see everybody and their mother texting these days, you know?
No, and it's just an explosion. Part of the evidence was that in Canada, there were something like 66 billion text messages sent in the year when this case came forward.
Wow.
60 billion of them from a high school lunchroom, probably.
Yeah.
the idea that this new technology is now going to really start to dominate the way we communicate, if for no other reason that we're moving to even voice communications taking place using new forms of technology, Skype, VoIP, all kinds of other forms of technology that if you took a hyper-technical approach to the law, which is what I would suggest the minority does here, if you take that kind of hyper-technical approach and don't look at the substance of what's happening, there's a danger that the result will be a regime where the state gets access to this information at too low a threshold.
Scott, it was not a unanimous decision, it was a split decision. So as a lawyer, what does that tell you?
Well, it tells me that the Supreme Court of Canada, like if you could take any seven people from Canada and say to them, what do you think of this issue? They're going to wrestle with it and they're going to come to a conclusion.
I would argue they're not any seven people.
Well, I've got to go back there, so I'm going to watch what I say.
Right.
But there's seven people who know a lot about this and have a chance to think about it, get arguments from the Crown and from people who know about how these technologies are developing, and they're trying to balance things. Don't forget, I mean, in theory, it would be open to Parliament to come up with a rule and legislate this in a slightly different way if they wanted to. I don't think that's what Canadians want. I think Canadians want a balance to be struck between privacy and police having appropriate powers to conduct these investigations. They want that balance to be struck in the same way as it's been struck for voice communications for a generation.
Scott, pleasure having you in the set. Thank you so much for your time.
My pleasure, thanks.
Scott Hutchison, lead lawyer representing Telus for that case, joining me right here in studio.